Can Billings and Williams in those situations continue to do that?
But China, that's Monique Billings' first field goal of the game as a nasty crossover by Erica Wheeler. And unfortunately, Odyssey Sims is on the highlight reel.
Erica Wheeler just got Odyssey Sims with the cross and then pulled back for the step back shot. E. Wheeler in the building.
Gets it to Vandersloot. 8 seconds to go. Vandersloot through the legs, cuts in, and lays it home to tie the game. Oh, what a move from Courtney Vandersloot.
They get the ball into Courtney Vandersloot. Steph Dolson comes out, slips the screen. Sloot. Now it's just up to her to create over the 6'9 Brittany Griner here. Changes pace. Wow, what a finish by Courtney Vandersloot.
18 points, 12 assists for Vandersloot. She ties this game.
Sparks, you know, when you've seen it and experienced it, especially as a young player, gives you a lot of confidence in the game.
You saw Noelle Quinn there, the local product, as Bird hits the deck and Wheeler knocks down the elbow jumper.
Lining up, finds Michaela Onyewede, but
excellent.
Too early. Perfect defense by Bradford.
Excellent defensive assignment right there by Bradford, who takes it in at the other end. Spin moves on Jasmine Jones and lays it in the basket for the and one.
Crystal Bradford, not just with the defensive series here, Tab, but finishing it with a nice move underneath.
Exactly. I mean, her confidence ever since being back in the league.
Spark player in double figures. Kaya Cooper, Neko Gumake now with 10 points and 7 rebounds. Brittany Sykes, Courtney Williams with a beautiful bucket and hushing the crowd. Right here, Courtney Williams with the cross and a couple ankles as well. By the way, add the bucket.
Here is Gray. There comes the high screen from Wilson. Gray one-on-one with Stewart. Connects on the jumper. With 10.6 to go.
Drain it. What a tough shot.
We heard Bill Laimbeer say to Chelsea Gray, does that work for you? Drawing up the final play, Gray said, yep, sure did. Oh, the little breakdown from Bradford, slipping it in, plus the foul. What a move from Crystal Bradford. Tie this game at 53.
On a run in transition, Bradford, little shake and bake. Oh, with the finish on the left flex on of Crystal.
She's been pretty quiet offensively so far to start. Here's Whitcomb. Between the legs, step back. That was pretty. Oh my, Sammy Whitcomb.
Derek Fisher near half court, giving instructions. Oh, what a feed! Oh, what a feed!
Erica Wheeler, the maestro, the conductor. That's 2 assists right here. Change of pace, and Amanda Sally B finishes.
McCowan to guard ball screen action. You found opportunities to attack the rim just like that. It clears the
ball's inbounded to Tolliver. Tolliver with 3. Tolliver stops, fall away jumper, she ties it! Christy Tolliver ties it and we're going to overtime!
WNBA Finals competed against one another. And here they find themselves guarding one another and leave it to Christy Tolliver to put the nail in the coffin. This is what she does. She gets to her spot.
2:40 left. Gray, Billings picks her up. Spin move. Oh my! And Alicia, you can go to the line.
She's different on this play. She's shifty. She's got every move. Finishes with the spin and one. She is going to the line. That was an incredible move.
Behind the basket, back out to Jisoo. Oh my! sharing the basketball. Chelsea Gray getting into the meat of the defense and then finds Jisoo Park on the short corner, and she knocks it down.
5 seconds difference from shot clock and game clock. Five. Tiffany Mays with the spin cycle. Venice, and I'm not sure how she got that one to fall, but it was definitely a beauty.
Is feeling it. Takes Vivian's off the dribble, hesitates, spins around Cannon McCowan, can't get there fast enough.
Tim. Whitcomb steps back and pans another three.
Well, Walker also had to, you know, not only the bubble, but, you know, fought the COVID-19 a little bit, a little floater by Skyler.